friends, good afternoon. I'm very thankful to Professor Deepak Pathak for initially giving me a chance to meet you in this occasion. I will just give you a small presentation for about 15-20 minutes, then we will have interaction as to how you can contribute or how you can be a part of the activities of ISTE. My name is Hariharan. I am from Indian Society for Technical Education. I started my teaching career in Chennai. I'm an assistant professor in engineering college in Chennai for 15 years. And from the year 1999, I took over as the projects coordinator and development coordinator in ISTE. And I'm in Delhi working for various national and international projects. And I'm also the editor of the newsletter and all the publications like journals and handbooks and other books. Let me start with this one. A small introduction about where we are in the country. Education shapes the destiny of a nation, as you all know, because you are all teachers. And particularly, the manpower which we are looking for, why people are not coming in large number to the field of engineering education. That is the million-dollar question we are trying to solve with the help of MHRD and AICTE. The quality of manpower in any country ultimately determines the sustainable well-being of its people. And you all know it's a liberating force which fosters growth, social equality, and technological progress. And recently, India, due to the advancement of globalization and internationalization of education, finding its own place in the international market, especially for knowledge workers. So in order to keep technological advances in control and subservient to the needs of mankind, engineering education and training requires a reprisal and prompt corrective action. What are the major issues in technical education as of today? The growth demand for education throughout the life cycle. It should be a lifelong learning, as you all know, that you cannot stop saying that I finished my studies and that's all. Every day you have to update your knowledge in order to spread this to your students. Changes to higher education brought on by technological innovation. What we have learned before is not that today. And some researchers, they tell that what we learn when we enter into an engineering course will become obsolete when we come out of this course. So internationalization of higher education, this is proved by many universities which are coming to India for MOUs, and still many universities are trying to enter into MOU with major universities, not only for knowledge sake, but for number. India has got a large number of students. And access and equity, where government plays a role, because government wants everyone to have access and equity. Everyone should be treated as equal. Then accountability, which is many people say which is missing as of today. Then differentiation of academic systems. There's a problem in the international education. Once if you finish your engineering education here, you cannot directly go and take up research or higher education in the Western countries, because this equality of degrees is not still there. We are working for that in that area. And what are the major challenges in technical education? The challenges for technical education and the engineering profession have also arisen from technological and organizational changes, and as I told, internationalization of business. And due to the rapid increase of IT industry and biotechnology and science and technology, there is some fundamental changes which are taking place. This has raised many questions, such as to what extent the qualification, education, and training and employment of engineers need to be embraced in order to meet these challenges and requirements. So the impact of competition, technological change, and microeconomic reform on employment, you all know that we are facing the global recession period. Increasing part-time, casual, and contract workers leads to the need for people to change jobs more often in a work life. There are heterogeneous views about the purpose of education, including renewed focus on social and civic values. The application of new technology to education and training is gaining ground. And everywhere, the government of India wants to spend more money on training teachers in order to make the younger generation more knowledgeable. Knowledge Society's recommendation, main recommendation, is to train teachers primarily. So one notices shifts in employment towards information workers away from traditional jobs and the need for on-the-job training in the workplaces. And these things I've just introduced you, and I'll just skip all these slides because you all know about the Indian higher education scenario right now. And the present government has given promise and given about 3,600 crores earmarked for technical vocational education and training as well. And they've upgraded many institutions to the level of national institutions, and they have promised to give 10 central universities, upgraded many institutions to IITs, national level institutions. RECs have been already converted, 20 RECs have been changed the name to National Institute of Technologies, and another 10 are coming. So MHRD is planning in a bigger way, following the recommendations of Knowledge Commission. So to give you a small idea about how we are, where we are, number of universities in India has grown from 19 in 1947 to 378 in 2007, and colleges from 27 to 18,000 and odd. So we are already adding 5 to 6 universities and 300 colleges every year to our educational system. This pertains not only to engineering colleges, but the general colleges also are in the picture. So what I'm trying to say is there is a tremendous growth in the field of education, and many people say that recession will not affect two main areas, mainly entertainment and education. There will not be any major effect in these two fields. So there is a galloping growth of institutes of higher learning in, that is also visible. So now, right now, we have about 367 universities, and it's still increasing every month. This will give you a picture about the growth of higher education system in India. The enrollment rate is in millions is increasing, has already increased. Universities are increasing, colleges, like that, they are in the upward trend only. The major aim of the education policy of the government in the post-independence era has been to provide free and compulsory education to all children, at least up to the primary and elementary stage. But then there is largely, there is a change in the shift, I mean shift in the policy, that more and more importance is given to higher education as of today. There is a gap, this is always there. People say that industry, the needs of the industry is not fulfilled by the institutions. Always it is a question raised, and we are trying to find solution for that every now and then. What I'm trying to say is the gap needs to be bridged through exponential increase in investments in higher education. So basically, in the field of technical education, we have a lot of potential where we can tap it. Knowledge service, including R&D, software development, IT-enabled services are in the upward trend, as I told you. And basically, the world is now looking for India for the knowledge workers. That's my thing on this, based on these 3 points. The central level of the technical education spectrum consists of AICTE, IITs, IIMs, then national universities, deemed to be universities, and then NITs, the National Institute of Technical Teachers Training Institutes, apprenticeship training and educational consultants, and all such major bodies I have listed. And of course, we have a tremendous amount of self-financing colleges and other institutions which are trying hard to train people. The key issues in technical and management education in the 11th plan would be a continued focus on increased intake capacity, enhancement of quality, which we are trying to achieve, faculty development, which has been given priority, optimization of resources through networking, the development of information technology education, improving quality and quantity of research and technologies, modernization and development of curriculum, international benchmarking, like we have an MBA in the field of technical education, which now they have changed this national policy of accreditation to international policy. They are going to follow the Washington Accord, which they have signed, based on the recommendations of the Abbott, which is going to come up from 1st April. So developing capacity in new and emerging technology areas, strategic planning and management of technical education system and informal sector development. In the case of informal sector development, Ministry of Labour has earmarked 1,500 crores, especially for the workers. The Government of India is planning to start on Workers Technical University in Hyderabad. They are just trying to fix the venue, I mean the state. This will come in the next academic year. Already work is in the progress. So to ensure quality in education, the University Grants Commission identifies the universities and colleges with potential for excellence, and they give money up to 1 crore for each and every university. And special assistant programs, about 40 lakhs to 100 lakhs have been given. UGC is working hard to improve the quality, and you all know about the TechU program funded fully by World Bank, and the TechU 2 is in the progress. Basically on vocational education, now you must have read in the newspaper about the ministry has given 3,700 crores earmarked exclusively for vocational technical education, and ISTE has been given responsibility to frame out a framework for implementing to all this vocational education, upliftment of all vocational education with the help of ISTE, I mean AICTE, we are working on it. And all these things, various vocational education schemes that are available. As I told you, the World Bank Assistance Scheme is doing well, and TechUp 3 is has already started from the Knowledge Commission report. You can browse this from the internet and you can get more details about that. So I'll skip a few slides and I'll go back to the ISTE part. The Indian Society for Technical Education is a national, professional, non-profit making society of engineering educators as well as students of technical institutions registered under the Societies of Registration Act of 1860. Association of Principals of Technical Institution was transformed into Indian Society for Technical Education in 1968 with a view to broaden its activities to advance the cause of technical education. See, in the year 1941, principals of all the engineering colleges, they joined together and formed an association which is called Association of Principals of Technical Institutions, and it went on up to 1967, and after independence they thought that there should be a body to monitor the quality intake and everything like your UGC, especially for the engineering education. So AICTE was born, and it was not initiated in the, as an act of parliament. That was done only in the year 1984. So ISTE is the mother of All India Council for Technical Education. The logo of AICTE, the fund, the formation rules, strategies, everything was formed with the help of ISTE only. So the major objective of the ISTE is to assist and contribute in the production and development of top quality professional engineers and technicians needed by the industries and other organizations. Being the only national organization of educators in the field of engineering and technology, ISTE effectively contributes in various missions of the Union Government. The Ministry of Human Resource Development, AICTE, Department of Science and Technology, Ministry of Information and Technology, state governments are all well associated with the ISTE for programs related to technical education. Remember, this is only a professional body. We don't give certificates. We don't conduct courses exclusively. We help institutions to conduct courses. We fund the institutions to run the courses with the help of Government of India. We as such don't have any courses. So what are the main objectives of ISTE? Formulate the general goals and responsibilities of technical education. Modify curriculum educational process to changing conditions. Develop effective teachers and educational administrators. Improve instructional methods and practices and administrative usages. Then enhance professional ideas and standards, foster research as complementary to teacher, cultivate fraternal spirit amongst the teachers, administrators, industrialists and professionals, bring about effective linkage between technical institutions, industry and society. And it has got a couple of awards also which I will be explaining to you. award honorary fellowships, awards, and prizes for furthering the objectives of technical education to encourage teachers to be in the field of engineering education. So the structure is like this. There is an executive council at a national level. No one is the owner of this ISTE. Every year, we elect from different parts of the country. An executive council is elected by the members of ISTE. They form the executive council. Out of the executive council members elected, they select the office bearers like president, vice president, and secretary. And we run the show for 3 years, and again there will be election and new faces will come. It is purely run based on the membership fees that we collect from teachers, and for all the projects we get funded from government and various other funding agencies. As I initially told you, we are not a profit making organization, we are a service organization for the development of teachers and engineering education. We have got 63,250 teachers as members, 1,95,000 students as members, student members, 1,680 institutional members. We have around 3,200 institutions, like both engineering institutions and as well as polytechnic institutions. Out of that, only 1,680 institutional members we have, and 957 faculty chapters. You may, if you have 50 members in one institution, you can form a chapter, and you can have your own office bearers for the chapters. Like that, we have 957 faculty chapters throughout the country. And likewise, instead of, I told you, if you have only 25 members, I'm sorry, if you have only 25 members, you can form a faculty chapter. And if you have 50 student members, you can form a student chapter. We have about 995 student chapters as of today. The membership fee is a very meager amount of 250 rupees per annum for teachers and 120 rupees for 4 years for students. Even a cost of Coke will not do if you go to the restaurant, and this, that's why I said we are not profit making. In return, you may ask, what will you give if you become a member? You are entitled to participate in all the workshops and training programs conducted through ISTE. Preference will be given for members, and you will get a bi-monthly newsletter which will give you information about what is happening in the field of technical education in the country. And if you buy our publications, you will get around 20 to 25% discount. Then what are the major activities of ISTE? Curriculum development and updating, which we regularly do every 5 years, and we recommend to AICTE. The AICTE's recommendations, broad guidelines of various curriculum is formed or is framed by ISTE only, with all the experts. AICTE sponsored short-term training programs, which in short called STTPs, for engineering teachers and practicing professionals, which is fully funded by MHRD through AICTE. Preparation of course materials, teacher manuals, and other institutional resource materials under ISTE Learning Materials Project, which is fully funded by Swiss Development Corporation. Preparation of learning materials for working professionals is selected in selected areas under ISTE WPLP, Working Professional Learning Project, which is also funded by MHRD, AICTE. Special short-term programs for teachers, industries, and other professional organizations. Time to time, we give money for them to organize. Then we conduct seminars, workshops, conferences on topics of relevance of technical education. We means institutions conduct, we give money to them to conduct. Information technology-oriented programs, conduct of entrepreneurship awareness camp for young teachers and students. Department of Science and Technology has given the responsibility to us to conduct various camps. Like what we conduct this STTP program, we also conduct this entrepreneurship development program, fully funded by DSTE. And every year we conduct around 200 programs throughout the country for both teachers and as well as for students. Then project formulation, implementation, and appraisal. If they come to us for help, we will give them help with the experts which we have. Then preparation of directories on technical education, which facilities and expertise. We compile the addresses of all the engineering institutions and the places from where in which you can get travel grants, research grants, various other governmental agencies where in which you can apply for other programs, all we compile. Then publication of a bi-monthly ISTE newsletter, publication of a quarterly Indian Journal of Technical Education. For the last 32 years, we have been publishing this. Then IST handbook, as I told you. Then learning materials. Then publication of various monograms. See, these learning materials was restricted only to the field of electronics and computer science under the SDC project. Now they said this can be extended to other faculties as well. Then what are the major aims and objectives? Major aim and objective for ISTE is to help the students in personality development, faculty members in career development, so as to produce high quality professionals needed by the institutions, industries and other organizations at national and international level. Then membership are classified into 5 different categories. Honorary fellowship, this we identify the major stalwarts of engineering education, we honor them, no fees for that, it is a honor for them. And life membership, you can become a life member by paying a fees of 2050 once and you can become a life member, and we will give you a plastic card like what the banks are giving, and with that you can have, you can enjoy the facilities of ISTE activities. Then annual membership for about 250 rupees. Then student membership for 120 rupees for 4 years. Then institutional membership, if your institutional is a member of ISTE, they have to pay 25,000 rupees once. Then you will become an institutional member, and IIT Mumbai is one of the earlier institutional members, say way back in 20 years before they have become members. This is about the membership graph that we have as of today, and annual membership, then life members, then student members. Then we conduct national convention for students. Every year we conduct a national convention where all the students are invited to a particular place. With the help of sponsorship from industries, we conduct. This has been started only before last, in the year 2001 only we have started this. So about 1,000 students will, from different institutions will come and take part in various competitions. To encourage them, we give them awards, prizes and everything. It's a grand get together for all the students of technical education, which will provide an opportunity for the students to meet each other. Then annual convention where teachers meet. This is conducted in the month of December every year. It's completely sponsored by state governments and MHRD, and more than 1,000 teachers will come, and one theme will be selected according to the current requirements. People will come and present papers, they discuss. This activity will be there for 3 days. You can meet people, experts, professors, Nobel laureates and things like that. And various other business meetings in the society will also be conducted during the annual convention. Then we have 15 sections following it up. Each section, suppose if you are in Maharashtra, Maharashtra and Goa section, you have to approach the office members. You can become an institution member or you can become a member forwarded through them, and you can be a representative. You may ask why this is required. This is required because from each section, based on the number of teachers present, for every 1500 members, one member will be elected for the executive council. So they form ISTE. Suppose you have about 10,000 members in Maharashtra, so you have divided by 1500, you have that many members which you will elect, teachers will elect. Out of these 10,000 people, 1% or 10% will be elected or 8% will be elected. They will go to Delhi, they will form the team, they will run the show. It's purely democratic. So at the national level, as I already told you, we have conducted so many summer schools and winter schools which we are popular for, and conducted, trained around 56,000 teachers in engineering college and 26,000 in polytechnics, purely funded by MHRD and AICT. We have a continuing education program where we have produced various models, and now we have stopped this because we are having linkage with all the IITs where they are producing with the help of this CEDP and other CEP programs. We are disseminating the information produced by them. Then every year we prepare the model syllabus, as I told you, for curriculum development we do this. At the national level, we conduct this awareness grams, training manuals, bi-monthly newsletter, conferences, and we have a scheme called professional visiting professor scheme, where a new engineering college who are expecting or who wants the services of an experienced professor, we pay them TADA and everything, local hospitality to be borne by the institution, and all their expenses will be borne by the ISTE. And you have to apply for ISTE for becoming a visiting professor for various institutions. Then international collaboration, we have represented UNESCO and AAESCA. We have participated in SEACP with the Canada project, Canada India Institutional Cooperation Project, then Industry Institutional Linkage Project from Canada, then Commonwealth Program, Association of Continuing Education Program, and all this we have participated and still we are a member. And as I told you, our World Bank project Impact, we have produced about 45 learning materials under World Bank and SDC and DOE. Then learning material project, which is still there, which is continuing right now. And then we are the member of World Federation of Association of Colleges and Polytechnics. And we have collaboration with International Federation for Engineering Education Societies, which is a new society formed 2 years before, which has come out from Association American Society for Engineering Education. That is there from 1879. So we are a member of that one. And they are bringing out a journal called Journal of Engineering Education. That JEE is going to complete its 100th year next year. So they thought that ISTE should involve, and they have come out with a solution saying that this can be obtained, say for a meager amount of 325 rupees if you are a member of ISTE. If you are a non-member, if you want to directly get the 4 issues of JEE, you have to pay 5,000 rupees. Say $100 you have to pay, but then they have given an opportunity for ISTE members, if you want to subscribe, you can subscribe for 325 rupees for 4 issues, inclusive of all the charges of posting and everything. So we have entered into an MOU with them and they have given, and we are printing here, and ISTE has been given the responsibility to publish this for this whole Asia Pacific region. And I am the editor for Asia Pacific region, and if you have any queries, you can write to me. Then what are the future of, we are planning for the future and we have got certain goals. We would like to have the distance education mode of technical education through e-learning. Now Professor Pathak is working very hard to put through this e-content through open source, and he is trying his level best to get the dissemination, the contents disseminated to all the technical teachers, and ISTE will definitely give him a full support in all his endeavors. And we are now in the same, we have got the same goal, and we will definitely cooperate with Professor Pathak and IIT CEP to achieve this goal. So development of informal technical education, as I told you, we are going to have the workers technical education, technical university in Hyderabad, which we are also a part of it, and we are going to establish a technical education national staff college. We don't have, we engineers, we don't have an academic staff college like what UGC is having. So we have already given a proposal to AICT and still it is pending. It has to be cleared from MHRD for funds. To create a national database on technical education system, which we don't have. Suppose you want to know how many civil engineers are there in the country, maybe you have to tell only approximate figures. But then we are planning to have a database with us. Suppose some huge project is going to be there, then we can give the database to various states and help them. So career planning, personality development for students and faculty development for teachers. Enhance number of short-term training program for technical teachers. Now, right now we are conducting around 400 programs per annum, which we are going to increase this to 1,000. That's our aim in the near future. So develop a mechanism for periodic professional refinement of faculty members. How? Whatever you do, there is a huge cry saying that it is not relevant or sufficient. So how to do this? So we'll have to work out on that and find out. So about, I told you about the visiting professor scheme, it is all available in our net, you can take it. Then this publication, you will get free of cost if you are a member, 6 issues of newsletter, and it is already appreciated by all the members and they are looking forward for all this, and the e-form of this one is in the net, you can get it. Then IJTE, Indian Journal of Technical Education, the last 33 years we have been publishing this. And I am the editor of this journal, and you can send the papers, research paper or referate, collated paper or a general article on pedagogy of technical, in the field of technical education, you can send it to me, and we will send this to a team of experts for blind review, and if it is of publication standard, if it meets the publication standard, we will publish that in the journal. Then I told you about the ISTE handbook. It contains a lot of information, and it is the unique kind where you don't have this type of handbook, especially for technical education. I don't think there is any publication of this sort. Then CICEP publication, we are only printing that, we are not doing anything. The articles are written by the Canadians. Then students primer, every 3 years we collect articles from expert teachers saying that how the students should behave in the class, about ragging, about attendance, how to pass the examination, how to face the examination, how to face the interview. Relating to all the students' affairs, we collect articles from experts and we publish this student primer, and it is sent free for all the students' chapters. We don't sell this. And it is our website address. You can take this, and it, we every fortnight we update this. Then, as I told you, we to encourage teachers and students, there are a number of awards, about 30 awards for students and about 27 awards for teachers, both national and regional level. We invite applications from students and teachers. We scrutinize this with the help of experts, and the award committee will select the award winners, and during the annual convention of students and teachers, it will be awarded to the award winners. So as I told you about the learning materials project, if you are really interested in writing a book, we encourage you. We publish this through leading publishers in the country, and you will be given royalty based on the number of copies sold. For the initial cast, you will be given some amount for typing another preliminary work. If you are really interested, straight away write to me, send an application, we will take up that issue. Then this working professional learning project, if you want to write a monograph for working professionals, people who are in the industry, you are welcome, send the application to me, we will scrutinize and we will get back to you. Then IET project, like this content development, IET also wanted ISTE to help. We have entered that in the month of July 2005, but unfortunately that project is not taking up because of their internal problems, but still that MOU is on. Then this Indo-UK REC project, the British Council has given funds for the teachers for exchange programs. Teachers from India will go there and spend about 2 years there. Teachers from UK come here. This is exclusively for the NITs. It was there in the year 1995 to 2002. So the British Council gave ISTE a chance to evaluate the performance of that entire Indo-UK REC project, and the chairman of this project was DP Agarwal, who is the UGC, I mean this UPSC chairman right now, and I had an opportunity to work with him to evaluate this project, and we have submitted the report to them. Then about this technical vocational education training program, AICT is very keen, and it is going to come up in a large way, big way. There is a meeting on Friday at Delhi, and a huge amount of money is going to be given for ISTE, and we have given a proposal like occupational training centers of ISTE, how it can be implemented and things like that. Funding will come from MHRD purely. Once it is finalized, I will put in the net and you can approach us for setting up of an occupational training center. Then entrepreneurship training, both for teachers and students, as I told you, this DST is giving funds, and we are the national coordinating agency for the entrepreneurship training centers. If you want to start an entrepreneurship cell also, you can write to us, we will help you. This is basically for teachers, for students, and they want to certify, ISTE to certify the courses conducted by various EDP cells, which we are working out, because there are some copyright issues in that one, IPR issues in that one, and that will be solved, and we are into that project also. Other projects which we are interested in, as I told you, that ASWE, American Society for Engineering Education, then TIFAC mission, you know about TIFAC, they are giving funds to start specialty and then core subjects, TIFAC core project. So we are the agency, or we are the one of the agencies to identify the experts for the TIFAC core mission project, and whatever TIFAC projects, wherever TIFAC project is implemented, IST will give helping hand to make them a big success. One of them is IIT Mumbai, our Pathak Saab's e-outreach project. We are playing a small role where the squirrel played in Ramayana. We are also playing a small role in Pathak's projects. And we have got this MHRD TVET project, which is also coming into a good shape. And another one is the IUCEE India project. We are the India partners. Indo-US Continuing Education, Indo-US Center for Engineering Education. So they conduct programs like what we do in ISTE, but then slightly different. It is fully funded by two great people, Deshpande and Infosys Narayan Murthy. Last year they conducted this program, 580 teachers were trained for 27 programs, for about a month, one and a half months. It was conducted fully residential program, as a fully residential program in Infosys Mysore campus. This year also we have got, this is a second one, which is going to be conducted from June 20th to July 15th or so. If you are interested, you go to that website and you can apply. And if you have any difficulty, I am the coordinator for the India mission. You can write to me. We will take up with that issue. Last time it was 2000 rupees for a course. This time it is 5000 rupees for a course. You can go through the various course details, what are the titles. If you are interested, apply in that one. We will facilitate and we will help you to get trained through this. But only difference is the person who is going to come and give lecture and go and conduct the class will come from US. Only US experts will come. Some Indians who are settled there will also come there. Last time about 56 US experts came to Infosys and gave lecture for about 1 week course. 27 courses were conducted. This year also we have. If you have any, if you're any interest, write to me, we will do it. Then we are planning to construct a guest house in IIT. I mean, we are in the IIT Bombay campus only. They have given land free of cost to us. And our building is built with the help of Canadian funds and MHRD funds. IIT Delhi. And the building was constructed with the help of MHRD fundings and Canadian fundings. Now we are planning to construct a guest house. This will be exclusively used for teachers who come to Delhi for various business purposes. They are finding it difficult to get the guest house accommodation and things like that. About 50 rooms will be there with the seminar hall and all the facilities, which is going to take up in another 2-3 months because we have a lot of difficulties with MCD and all those. We will not pay any single pie to anybody and we will not grease the palms of anybody. And that is our policy. And with the normal speed, it took 3 years for us to get the permission from MCD. They have already given permission and funds are with us. Various institutions have given. We have collected more than 1 crore exclusively for this building fund. And this guest house construction project is for about 3.5 crores so that all the teachers in the country can go. If it is available, they will be given priority at a very minimum rate for the operational expenses only. That is our next project. And institutions from the south, major about 60 lakhs we have collected from institutions from the south, exclusive from self-financing people. They are ready to give and they are very generous to give. This, some of the pictures I would like to show. These are all the plan that we are planning to from the architect, the existing building and the building plans. Thank you very much for your patience. And if you have any questions as to how to approach for various projects, we will have a discussion for another 10 minutes or so.